It's impossible to ignore the monumental influence Gucci has on the global fashion scene. This Italian luxury brand has left an indelible mark on the world, shaping and reshaping the way we perceive style, elegance, and luxury. From the bustling streets of New York to the chic avenues of Paris, from Tokyo's vibrant districts to the colorful markets of Mumbai, Gucci's presence is felt, seen, and revered. There's a unique blend of tradition and innovation that sets Gucci apart. It's a brand that has managed to stay true to its Italian heritage while constantly pushing boundaries, daring to be different, and unafraid to challenge the status quo. This balance between the old and the new is what makes Gucci a timeless powerhouse in the fashion industry. Gucci's appeal is broad and transcends the typical boundaries of age, gender, and culture. It's not just a brand for the young, the hip, or the affluent. It's a brand for everyone. It's a brand that has managed to capture the imagination of people from all walks of life, from the high school student saving up for their first Gucci item to the seasoned fashionista with an extensive collection. The iconic double G logo is instantly recognizable worldwide, a symbol of quality, luxury, and style. It's more than just a fashion statement, it's a testament to the brand's enduring popularity and influence. Gucci's influence isn't confined to the realms of fashion alone. It has permeated the world of art, music, and film, becoming a cultural phenomenon in its own right. It's a brand that is not just worn, but celebrated, and its influence resonates across the globe. And yet it's not just about the clothes, the shoes, or the accessories. It's about the story behind the brand. A story of a humble leather goods company that has risen to become one of the world's most revered luxury fashion houses. Indeed, Gucci's rise to the top is a tale worth telling, a journey filled with passion, innovation, and resilience. Our story begins in 1921 in the heart of Florence, Italy, where Guccio Gucci opened his first store. Guccio Gucci, the man behind the brand, was born into a modest family in Florence. His father was a humble leather craftsman, and it was from him that Guccio inherited his love for quality craftsmanship. However, his vision went beyond the confines of his hometown. Young Gucci found himself drawn to London, a city known for its refined aesthetic and sophisticated taste. There, he worked as a bellhop at the Savoy Hotel, where he was exposed to a world of luxury and elegance. The wealthy patrons, their fine luggage, and the grandeur of the hotel itself deeply influenced Gucci. His time in London sparked an idea, a vision of blending the refined aesthetic he had seen with his own Florentine heritage. Upon his return to Florence, Gucci was armed with more than just a vision. He was filled with a burning desire to create something of his own, something that would reflect the elegance and sophistication he had seen in London. And so, in 1921, he opened the doors of his first shop. It was a small store, but it was filled with big dreams and even bigger aspirations. The shop was a testament to Gucci's love for quality and craftsmanship. It specialized in leather goods and luggage, products that mirrored the refined aesthetic Gucci had admired in London. Each piece was meticulously crafted, showcasing the exquisite Florentine craftsmanship that Gucci's father had passed down to him. These initial products were more than just items of utility. They were a reflection of Gucci's vision, a blend of London's refined aesthetic and Florence's renowned craftsmanship. They were the first steps of a journey that would take Gucci from a small store in Florence to global recognition. From these humble beginnings, a fashion empire began to take shape. The tale of Gucci is a testament to the power of vision, the allure of quality, and the magic of craftsmanship. It shows us that even the humblest of beginnings can give rise to greatness. The 1950s and 1960s marked a period of expansion and innovation for Gucci. This era opened a new chapter in the Gucci Chronicles, a time when the brand began to experiment and introduce products that would soon become iconic symbols of luxury and status. Picture this, the year is 1955. Gucci unveils a product that screams innovation, the bamboo handle bag. Due to post-war rationing, traditional materials were in short supply. Gucci, never one to shy away from a challenge, decided to think outside the box. They turned to bamboo, a material abundant and easily moldable under heat. The result? A bag with a unique, exotic appeal that quickly became a fashion sensation. Fast forward to the swinging 60s and Gucci introduced another trend-setting innovation, the horsebit loafer. This shoe, with its distinctive metal horsebit detail, was a nod to Gucci's equestrian roots. It was comfortable, stylish, and versatile. Soon, it became a staple in the wardrobes of the fashion-forward crowd. But the innovation didn't stop at the product line. Gucci was also pushing boundaries in terms of its presence on the global stage. In the mid-50s, Gucci crossed the Atlantic, opening a store in the heart of New York City. This move was followed by another milestone in 1961 when Gucci opened its doors in London. These were bold steps, positioning Gucci as a truly international brand. And of course, we can't talk about Gucci's rise without mentioning the celebrities who fell in love with the brand. Hollywood stars, musicians, and socialites began donning Gucci, further boosting its profile. The likes of Audrey Hepburn and Jackie Kennedy were spotted with the bamboo bag, while the horsebit loafer graced the feet of many a celebrity. This era solidified Gucci's reputation as a trendsetter, a status it continues to uphold. Through innovation and expansion, Gucci made its mark on the world of fashion, proving that the combination of creativity, daring, and quality craftsmanship is a recipe for enduring success. Like any great empire, Gucci too faced its fair share of struggles. There's no grand narrative without a bit of conflict, and Gucci is no exception. In the 80s and 90s, the fashion house wasn't strutting down the runway, it was stumbling. Family disputes tore at the seams of the company. The Gucci lineage, once a harmonious blend of business and blood, was now riddled with infighting. The family members, each struggling for control, steered Gucci towards a labyrinth of chaos. The feud was not just a family matter, it was a brand crisis. Adding fuel to the fire, Gucci found itself embroiled in a tax evasion scandal. This tarnished the brand's image and the trust of its loyal clientele was shaken. The Gucci name, once synonymous with luxury and elegance, was now associated with controversy and scandal. As if the family disputes and tax evasion weren't enough, Gucci also faced brand dilution. Over-licensing led to a flood of products that were far removed from the brand's luxury roots. Gucci's iconic double G logo was stamped on everything from cigarettes to keychains, diluting the brand's exclusivity and luxury appeal. But like the legendary Phoenix, Gucci would rise from these ashes. A turning point came with the appointment of Tom Ford as creative director in 1994. Ford, with his bold and provocative designs, managed to breathe new life into the brand. He reimagined Gucci's aesthetic, steering it away from the brink of bankruptcy and back into the world of high fashion. His daring designs and innovative approach rekindled the brand's allure, and Gucci began to reclaim its position in the luxury market. The struggles that Gucci faced were not just obstacles, but opportunities for growth and reinvention. From family feuds to financial fiascos, every challenge was a stepping stone, pushing Gucci to redefine itself and its place in the fashion world. Against all odds, Gucci emerged stronger, more resilient, and more influential than ever. The brand's journey is a testament to the power of resilience and reinvention in the face of adversity. In the 21st century, Gucci continues to redefine fashion. This epoch has been marked by the appointment of Alessandro Michele, a visionary whose creative prowess has been instrumental in the brand's meteoric rise. With his appointment as creative director in 2015, Gucci experienced a seismic shift, moving from its minimalist leanings to a world of maximalism, a world where more is more and where each piece tells a story. Michele's Gucci is a realm of imagination, a kaleidoscope of motifs, patterns, and textures. It's a fashion utopia where the old and new, the classic and contemporary, meet in a vibrant fusion. This daring approach, this audacious spirit, is what sets Gucci apart in the 21st century. In this digital age, Gucci has not just adapted but embraced the power of social media, using it as a tool to connect, engage, and inspire. It has become a platform to showcase the brand's vibrant aesthetics, its rich heritage, and its forward-thinking vision. This digital embrace has allowed Gucci to reach a global audience, expanding its influence far beyond the confines of the traditional fashion world. But Gucci's evolution is not just about aesthetics and digital innovation. It's about a commitment to creating a better, more sustainable future. Gucci has been at the forefront of sustainability in the fashion industry, championing initiatives such as the Carbon Neutral Challenge and the Gucci Equilibrium Program. These efforts underscore the brand's dedication to reducing its environmental footprint and promoting social justice. Moreover, Gucci's involvement in social causes, from supporting gender equality to championing mental health awareness, demonstrates its belief that fashion is more than just clothes. It's a platform to make a difference, to spark conversations, and to incite change. Today, Gucci stands as a testament to its enduring legacy, the power of creativity, and the relentless pursuit of excellence. As we look towards the future, one thing is certain: Gucci will continue to shape the world of fashion, one bold, beautiful design at a time.